Hi, Riata Scott back with you for part 2 of creating a newsletter from scratch in InDesign CS6. In this video, we'll take a quick look at the InDesign interface. So this is the new document we created in the first video. This is the document page. The black outline shows the page boundaries. The pink outline shows the margins. And the purple outlines show the three columns. The area outside of the page is the pasteboard, and things you put on the pasteboard won't print, so it's a good place to keep notes or maybe content that you're not ready for. This is the tool panel. It has all the tools that we'll be using. Mostly we'll be using this black arrow at the top. That's the selection tool. Anytime you're on another tool, let's say we're on this, click V on your keyboard, pop you right back to the selection tool again so that we can select objects. You'll notice that some tools have a little triangle in the corner. That means that they're part of a tool group, and if you click and hold or right click them, you'll see the other tools in the group and you can just choose one this way. This is the control panel, and it's contextual, meaning that it changes depending on what tool or object you have selected. If I click the text tool, for instance, I'll get the character or paragraph formatting controls up here. This is the application bar. Most actions can be found in these menus as well as by using shortcuts and right clicks. The window menu shows what panels you have open, and you can use it to open or find other panels. Right now we have a check mark beside control, and that's the control panel, and tools, and that's the tool panel. And then of course we have this document open. You can see the tab there. If we had more than one document open, we'd have tabs for them and we would have a list of them right here. Let's take a look at the panel dock. That's this. These are panels that are docked on the panel dock. These are icons actually, and if we click one, then the panel actually opens up, and each group has tabs to show the others behind it. So in this group we have pages, layers, and links. And we can click this to collapse it. We can move these out, so if we wanted to have our stroke open all the time, say, we could move it out like that. Move it back. And you can move these around, put them in different configurations, add more from window up here, maybe styles, paragraph styles. That's one I use a lot. And you can click and drag, and when you see the blue line, let it go, and then it is there. And if you want to save these as a workspace, once you get it looking the way you want to, you would click up here in the workspace switcher, new workspace, and give it a name. I am going to reset Essentials since I messed it around and I want it to be basic for the rest of these lessons, so I'll click Reset Essentials. One last thing I want to mention is almost every panel has a panel menu here in the corner, and that just gives you more options related to that panel. So that was a quick look at the InDesign interface. We'll become more familiar with the various tools, panels, and shortcuts as we begin adding content to our newsletter in the next videos. Before I end this video, I'd like to mention that IT Training offers free beginning and advanced courses in InDesign as well as other software for all students and staff. So if you're interested in learning more, log into training.missouri.edu today and register for a class.